God. Hey, everybody out there. This is John.
And this is Ben.
Welcome to Cinema Gulp today.
And today we're reviewing Brightburn. Off the heels of another superhero film, which finds a young boy suddenly gaining superpowers in Shazam, comes Brightburn. This features a kid who sort of grows up like Superman, only he's fucking insane. This movie sucks.
Yeah, this movie fizzled right from the beginning. Fucking terrible. It was certainly not bright.
Welcome back, John.
I had a high anticipation for this movie. I think I mentioned it in our anticipation video on New Year's. That little trailer that I did catch was very intriguing. I mean, it didn't have any filmmakers behind it that I was expecting to put out something amazing, but I really had high hopes for this movie, and boy, did it let me down.
Well, that trailer is all there is. This is one of the lowest budgeted movies I've seen that does not... I don't know what the budget was. I'm sure it was... God, it must have been low, because it was just... It was all over the place that they couldn't show this. They couldn't show this. That's fine. You don't always have to show. But the director of this movie wasn't crafty enough to utilize what he had to make something really... To make something really unique, which is all I really wanted out of this. Mm-hmm. I didn't need... Like, the only thing you can say about this movie that had any entertainment value is it had a couple of good gory moments. But I don't need that. And it's like... If that's all you have to offer, then why come up with the concept of an evil Superman... It's just, this movie is such a wasted opportunity.
Yeah, a waste of only an hour and a half in the theater.
Thank God.
It really did feel like 3 hours. Even at the end of this movie, it seemed like it was setting up like a third act that was going to be pretty long. And it came and went very quick in the third act.
At least that got a setup. This movie has no setup.
Yeah.
You know nothing about what's going on. If you haven't seen the trailer, then you're like, well, what does any of this mean? And... The character motivations.
Won't find out by the time
no,
the movie's over.
No, and the character motivations don't have any backstory. There's no progression of our character, who's supposed to be sort of this young kid who finds out he's from another planet, and then he has superpowers. There's no progression to that. There's no reason for why he acts the way he acts and does the things he does, which are horrific.
Yeah, there's a couple things that I thought they were trying to clue us into to maybe why some of this was happening, but they never flesh that out by the end of the film. It makes no sense by the end of the film. They don't fill in any of the gaps. The characters are the biggest problem for me in this movie. There needed to be a protagonist, somebody you could care about. And there really is. I mean, I guess if Elizabeth Banks is considered the protagonist, she's written so poorly.
She's all over the place.
These characters make the worst decisions in the movie. They're so clueless, even all the way into the third act, when it's clear that, you know, there's problems with this kid, that he's doing things that need to be reported to basically the FBI at this point.
Not the town sheriff.
Yeah, and they're clueless right to the end, and it's just infuriating watching this movie, just groaning every time they make a stupid decision. Let's go camping! Take the kid camping! Yeah.
This movie feels like it was written by a 10-year-old.
Yeah.
Like, it's just... It's kind of gross, and it's kind of... The idea that there's this really creepy scene where he's kind of stalking a classmate, and these are like 11, 12-year-old kids, is really gross to know that like a grown man wrote that. And I don't know, it's kind of sleazy. It was very sleazy fucking piece of crap.
So maybe Hollywood shouldn't welcome the Gunn family right back in? It was just poorly made. I mean, there was no tension ever in the film.
No.
The characters were so stupid, poorly written.
I would have loved it if it... just really did play out like Superman, where like he is a kid and he slowly finds out what he can do and his parents are helping him along with it, and he is a good kid, he's good at heart, and the tragedy is the evil of men and what he sees bad in this world is what shifts him.
I feel like honestly he should be the protagonist, and he's kind of supposed to be, I guess, but he should be the protagonist and antagonist so that we have that, you know, that struggle, that inner struggle that we're seeing him
just a horror movie a villain.
Yes,
he's like Chucky, like the way they use him, it's always from the perspective of the person he's going to kill.
Mm-hmm.
And he's just zipping around like a creature. Yeah, that would have been great if it was all from his perspective and what he thinks he's doing.
Yeah.
But this movie's not nearly smart enough for that. Directed by Shitty McFuckster.
It really was just poorly directed at every turn. Like, so many things that happen off screen. As you mentioned, maybe that was budgetary concerns, but it certainly stands out. It's still a directorial choice. These edits, these choices, to the way they end scenes almost every time had me going, what the fuck? That was how that's how that scene plays out? That's where we end it?
Yeah.
It was just terribly made.
How is this movie not tense? Like, you have a kid with superpowers who... It's not tense because we have no reason to care, and we don't know why he's doing what he's doing.
And they also spend no time at the beginning developing him as a kid, like to where, no. where we could just be interested in him as a normal kid. That's and start what, yeah. to see him see the changes happen. The family see the changes happen. It all happens so immediately in the film.
One scene of him like, so, oh, he gets picked on by classmates.
Yeah.
I don't know, man. Just the sleepwalking thing and like that, the whole story with the thing. It's just like, no, just show us up front. Just show us what's going on and don't. I mean, who does dream sequences anymore? I piggyback with you. The direction was bad. The writing was atrocious. The editing was bad. The acting was kind of bad.
The acting was bad. Yeah, I felt like it was TV-style acting.
It was TV-style acting, and just the lines they had to read were so... Yeah.
I recognized a few faces as character actors, but I could never tell you their names or what movie I know them from.
Yeah, the dude from the... Roy from The Office. I think his name was Roy.
Sheriff Sheriff
Scatman Crothers.
Splatman
Crothers. I called the shit out of that one.
Yeah.
It doesn't take a rocket science to figure it out. Cause yeah. That's another thing. There's not a single death in this movie that you don't see coming a mile away. And pretty much just plays, just telegraphs itself out exactly the way it's supposed to. There's no like, oh my god, that was insane. Nothing.
Well, I think there was one character in the entire film that, you know, typical horror movie, as soon as a character walks on screen, you go, live or die, is this person going to make it through the film? And I think there was only one that I was wrong about.
Yeah, I hated this movie. I'm disappointed. Superman goes crazy. Could have been so cool. There could have been a first half of it that could have been almost like John Hughes-ish, mixed with a little bit of Mom, Pa, Kent teaching him the ways of life. A man that wasn't just a bumbling moron like the dad in this movie. Like a dad who, I understand it's not Superman. It's its own Brandon Brewster or whatever the fuck his name is.
Brewster.
Could have played, if it had played out like that and gotten you to care about the family and gotten you to care about the boy, then everything that happens afterwards just would have actually had context to it. It would have had substance. It would have had meaning. But unfortunately, it didn't. I gotta give Brightburn one gulp. That gulp is basically because there's a cool glass in the eyeball shot, and that's pretty much it.
I'm right there with you. Every sentiment you just said, I agree with. I'm going to go even lower because I feel let down because I really, really wanted to enjoy this movie. And how much lower can you go than a one? I'll give it half a point. That's all I'm going to give this fucking movie because I really wanted out of that theater. I was hating this movie. At only an hour and a half, I was squirming in my seat wishing I could get the fuck out of there.
Yeah.
I heard you. I got a voicemail from work and I wanted to go check it, honestly. I was like, this is probably more important than what I'm doing right now. So, yeah, and I never want to see this filmmaker get another opportunity. I know that's sounding really harsh. But,
well, I'm sure he'll get Jurassic Park something.
That's true, yeah.
Because he's an indie guy. He did so much with so little. Let's give him $300 million.
I mean, give him some TV work. Maybe he can work on whatever Twilight Zone shit's going on TV right now. But
No, he doesn't deserve it. Give me the money. I'll make a better movie right now. Have you seen Infinity Space?
Just check it out.
Well, I was going to drink this beer, but not happening.
Pour one out for the filmmakers. So we hope you enjoyed this review of Brightburn. Check us out on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. If you enjoyed this review, please give us some comments in the comment section below. Hit the subscribe button and the notification bell. For Cinema Gulp, this is John.
This is Ben.
We drink your cinema.
I drink it up!
Would you like to play a game of hide and seek now? Please promise not to peek around. Well, first we count to 10, and then we'll